So JavaScript is basically a functional part of a web page. JavaScript is functional part of a web page. And how many ways to write JavaScript? There are many ways. One is inline JavaScript. One is internal JavaScript. One is external JavaScript. And one more is online editor. You can follow online editors. And one more is browser console. Browser console. So we already discussed about inline JS, internal JS, external JS. Am I right? We already discussed about inline JS, internal JS, external JS. So let it be. I want to continue with the inline JS. Inline JS is element specific JS, element specific JavaScript, or element specific JS. One is internal JS. How to write internal JS? Internal JS is page specific JS. Page specific JS or JavaScript. And this could be working with script tag open and script tag close. So inside the script tag, I want to write all the JS code. Whatever the JS code you have, that JS code you put inside the script tag. This is what actually available for you. Inline JS, internal JS. And one more is external JS. How to connect with external JS? External JS will be available. External JS will be available. A separate file. This will be application level JS. And here you can able to create a separate file, file.js. And this particular file.js, you can able to write all the JS code, whatever you have. Suppose inside the file.js, I'm writing all the JS code. And finally, we are going to be trying to accessing that JS into the file.html. How to access the complete JS code into the file.html? Script open src. Src is equal to file.js. And script close. This is called external JavaScript. I thought we already discussed about completely programs, inline JS, internal JS, and external JS. Am I right? We already discussed about the programs for the inline, internal, external. Yes. Okay. So finally, we will go for the online editors. There are multiple kind of online editors which are available for JavaScript. There are multiple kind of online editors which are available for the JavaScript. The most important one is jsbin.com. You can try work with the jsbin.com. And one more is CodePen. You can try to work with the CodePen. A lot of online editors which are available. I'm going with jsbin.com. Try with the jsbin.com how this JavaScript is working for. So try to open jsbin.com where you can do practice for the JavaScript. This is HTML, this is output. I don't want to write HTML, I'm writing JavaScript now. So JavaScript is something like alert. So alert box is coming directly, so for you. And here JS is loading something. So whenever you are trying to writing something, it is going to be executing for you. This is what actually online editor. The one more is browser console. You can write JavaScript in browser console also. How to write JS with browser console. So open any browser and go with console. Go with the browser console. For each and every browser, browser console is available. And there you can try to do write some JavaScript code. For example, I will go and create a new program for Google Chrome. A file, new file. This will be for browser console. Save it as. And I'm creating on desktop, I'm creating a file called a folder called CGG. And inside the folder, I'm going to be creating the date called 27 by 9. And inside the 27 by 9, I'm saving the file. This is the browser underscore console, console.html. Okay, so what I'm doing is open browser console for JS practice. Let me try to execute this one. So open in default browser. You will be having browser console. Open browser console for JS practice. Right click on this, go to inspect here. In inspect, you can have the window called console window, and where you can do practice with your JavaScript. I'm trying to write some JavaScript code. So JS and execute it. So I got a JS here. JS got fine. And I'm trying to write some variable here where x equal to 10. And what is the x value now? 10. Where y equal to 20. What is the y value now? 20. And x plus y. What is the x plus y? 30. See, everything is possible with the browser console, where you can do practice with the browser console, your JavaScript. But most of the people working with the browser console to debug your application. So browser console is very important. I will tell you later how to debug your application. Browser console is very important for debug application. And browser console used for check errors and resolve. So 2 points are very important. Browser console is very important for debug application, and browser console used for check errors and resolve, very important for browser console. Okay, let me try to go with the browser console application, and where I'm trying to writing some script file. So inside the script, I'm trying to writing one more alert box here. So alert, okay. So if I execute this particular HTML, I have to see this alert box. But I did already one mistake for the alert. So alert is not coming. Why? Because this is not compiler. If it is the compiled programming, automatically compiler error will come. But this is not working with compiler. You can able to go to the browser console inspector, check with the console. What is the output here for the console? Console issue. Some issue is there in your code. That is you can able to solve here from this. And click on this one, and you got understand where I'm doing the mistake. That mistake is very simple. So you are having some problem with alert, uncaught reference error, alert is not defined. You may understand, okay, I'm doing some mistake with alert now. So I can change the alert like this. So this is the way for the browser console. Browser console basically working for solve the issues. I told you browser console is very important for debug application. Browser console used for check errors and resolve. Very important, guys. Okay, so don't forget about browser console. For JavaScript debugging, for JavaScript error resolution, browser console is very, very important. I hope you got understand how the browser console is. Anybody having questions with this? Please respond in the chat box. I will continue further. Okay, fine. The next concept in JavaScript. Let me write some more important methods in JavaScript one by one. Some more important methods in JavaScript. So how JavaScript node point I'm writing. One important node point for the JavaScript. Note. JavaScript is case sensitive. What is this case sensitive? Capital is capital. Smaller is smaller. So you have to write a capital letter and small letter. Case sensitive. If you miss the capital letter or if you miss the small letter, automatically you get interpret error. Capital letter is capital letter, small letter is small letter. So suppose, for example, alert, this is right, but when I go with this, this is wrong. So this is actually right syntax. This is a right syntax. And when I write alert same like this, this is the wrong syntax. So you got understand what is this case-sensitive topic is. Case-sensitive topic is very important. Every programming language is case-sensitive most of the time. Every programming language is case-sensitive most of the time. And one more important point we have to remember is, in JavaScript, statement end semicolon is optional. Semicolon is optional. It means what? Semicolon is not required. Semicolon is not required. Semicolon is optional. And semicolon is required. Semicolon is required when we write multiple statements in the same line. When we write multiple statements in same line. When we write multiple statements in same line. Whenever we are writing multiple statements in the same line, semicolon is required. But whenever you are writing a line by line code, semicolon is optional. And one more important topic I will tell you, comments in JavaScript, comments in JS. So there are two type of comments, guys. Okay, the one is single line comment. The single line comment. One is the multi line comment. Multi line. So how we can provide a single line comment? How we can provide multi line comment? Single line comment will be like this, and code, JS code. And multi-line comment is also very simple. Whenever you have the multi-line comment, you can go like this. Multi-line comment, you will be writing a lot of code like statement one, and you can write one more statement, number of statements you can write, statement one, statement two. I'm writing two more statements like this, and this one is the multi-line comment. Whenever you want to provide multi-line comment, the syntax is like this. And whenever you have the single-line comment, syntax is like this. So let's go for the one program. What is this case-sensitive and what is this comments and all? Next, save. New program. This will be about comments. Okay, script open, script close. Now where I am writing multiple lines, guys. Okay, so where x equal to 10, and where y is equal to 20, and where z equal to x plus y. Okay, so I just want to print the z. console.log. So try to understand this. We are writing four lines of the code. First line, we are actually giving the semicolon. Second line, I'm not giving semicolon. And third line, I'm not giving semicolon. Even fourth line also, I'm not giving semicolon. Semicolon is optional. Whenever you have the statements in JavaScript, you're putting semicolon, you're not putting semicolon, not a problem. Understand? You're not putting semicolon at the problem. But whenever I'm writing multiple statements in the same line, for example, where x equal to 10, I'm writing multiple statements in the single line. Where y equal to 20, where z is equal to x plus y. And in this time semicolon is important. console.log z. Can you see, observe this, same program I'm writing, but I'm, whenever I'm writing with the multiple lines, semicolon is optional. You're not putting semicolon, not a problem. Or you're putting semicolon, not a problem. But when we have a multiple line, multiple statements in the single line, then semicolon is compulsory. Semicolon is compulsory. Why? Because I just want to make a separate the code of statements with multiple lines. This is important. And let us go with the comments. How to write the comments in single comments. Suppose, for example, I am writing a simple alert box. I just want to give the comment for the single line. Whenever you want to give the comment for the single line, there should be go. And whenever I want to write the multiple lines comment, I can go like this. I can go like this. How to write a multiple comment? You can take like this. Take like this. This code is commented now. This code is commented. This is a multi-line comment. This is a multi-line comment, but this is the single-line comment. And semicolon where you require, semicolon is required whenever we are writing multiple statements in the same line. Whenever we are writing multiple statements in the same line, a semicolon is compulsory. It is required. So the semicolon is making you differences between the each and every statement. This is about comments. Everybody got understand comments? Can I go for the next program? Next topic? Can I go? Yes. Yes. Thanks. Thanks. So let it be. So I'll go for the next program now. The next concept is very simple concept. I just want to give a document.write function. What is this document.write function? And one more function is console.log. One more function is console.log. And one more function is alert function. We already know alert function, but I'm trying to write it one more time. These three functions are very, very important in JavaScript. The first function is document.write. What is the purpose of document.write? Document.write function is using for print output on browser. And document.write is using for create a dynamic JavaScript. Or dynamic HTML. Okay, for example, I will write one simple example how document.write will be. Document.write will take single quotes or double quotes. Single quotes or double quotes. Both will work, okay? And let me take document.write hello.js. I'm writing this one. This will work. And document.write double quotes also take hello.js. No problem. Single quote, double quote, both will work. And one more thing I'm telling, document.write will using for create a dynamic HTML. I want to create a H1 on top of the browser. You can write a document.write like this. Document.write, you can create H1, dynamic H1, hello.js, and H1 is getting close inside the double quotes. This is what actually, without writing HTML, with the JavaScript, I'm creating the HTML. For that dynamic HTML, whenever you want to create document.write is very, very important. Okay, let me take one simple program for the document.write. Take new program, save it as document.write.html. Okay, so let me write some script now, guys. So let me write a document.write. Hello.js. And one more point I'm writing. So everything I'm copying here. So the first one is document.write hello.js. The second one is document.write hello.js. And third one is document.write with the H1. I'm creating simple H1 over there. And I'm creating a division here. Let me create a division. And this also, this should be close. Let me create a list item. Document.write, I want to create a list item. How to create list? Order list, unordered list. Order list open, order list close. Inside order list, I want to create a list objects. Li, the first one is Apple, APPLE. And Li is closed. And I want to have multiple list objects. First one is Apple, second one is Samsung, the third one is Oneida. So let me execute it. So if I execute this in the default browser, I will be having lot of things. Can you see observe? First one is Hello.js, second one is Hello.js, and H1, this one is H1, and this one is your order list or unordered list. You people, please ping me in the chat box. What is this order list? I created order list from JavaScript I'm creating the order list. This is called a dynamic HTML is required in real time. So that particular dynamic HTML I can able to go, and I want to take a break here. Document.write. So copy the document.write. I am taking a break tag. How to take a break tag? So this one is a break, right? So just check the output now. So hello.js, breaked. And this one is your H1. This one is your paragraph. This one is your ordered list. See, I can able to create my HTML dynamically from JavaScript. That is the purpose of document.write. And one more function is console.log. What is about console.log? So let me tell you, console.log is useful for console outputs. And console.log allowed single quotes or double quotes. Okay, so how to write console.log? So very simple syntax, console.log and single quotes hello.js. So one more point I will tell. Console.log is output back of the browser, and document.write output is front of the browser. So what is the back of the browser? What is the front of the browser? What user can able to see is document.write. What user cannot able to see directly is console.log. Console.log is very, very important for application tracking. It is very important to understand flow of the application. Okay, so please remember it. Desktop and CGG. So inside CGG 27, this is JavaScript logs. Okay, fine. I'm going with the console.log example. How to write console.log? Take a new program, save it as console.log.html. Writing script and console.log. So hello.js. Where is the output of the console.log? Open in default browser and right click on this. Go to the console window. How to go to console window in Chrome? Inspect it. Go to console. There you can see the output of the console. Output of the console is hello.js. Hello.js got printed in the console window, not on top of the browser. Remind it. Document.write is output on top of the browser. Console.log output is back of the browser. Back of the browser means console window of the browser. Everybody got understand what is the difference between the document.write and console.log? Please ping me in the chat box. Okay, thank you. So one is the console.log, one is the document.write. Document.write able to print outputs on top of the browser. Console.log able to print outputs in the console window. That's it. And coming to the alert box. Alert. What about alert? Alerts. Alert is a JS function which will work or which will show a pop-up on window. To give alert messages, correct, Marasa. So alert is a JS function which will show a pop-up window. That's it. So alert will allow, one more point I will write. Alert will allow single quotes or double quotes. Single quotes or double quotes. Double quotes, single quotes, double quotes. So write a syntax for alert. Syntax for alert is very simple. Alert, you can write a single quotes. So hello JS, alert, single quotes, hello. Both are working, both will work. Okay, so let me write a program for alert now. You know already how to write alert box, you know, alert.html. So script. Alert hello JS, alert I am learning UI development. I am learning UI development. So fine, save it and run in default browser, and you can see the first alert hello JS, second alert is I am learning UI development. See, alerts are basically using for to check the flow of the application again. Alert basically using for check the flow of the application. Alert works for check application flow or functional flow. Functional flow. Very important. So this is the one more message. So we discussed a lot of methods in the JavaScript. The first important method is document.write. Second method is console.log. Third method is alert function, and lot of things. And let me go with the prompt message. What about prompt method? Prompt is a JavaScript function. Take input from browser. From user. Prompt is a JavaScript function, take input from the user. So I will create a one simple application how to work with the prompts. Let me create a new and save it as prompt.html, and let me write some script over there. Script open, script close, where x is equal to, or where first name is equal to, I want to take a prompt value, prompt of. So enter first name, and I'm taking one more variable where last name, first underscore name this one, last underscore name this one, enter last name. Okay. And finally, where full name is equal to first name, string concatenation I'm doing now, first name plus and last name, first name plus last name. I'm just giving a space for this. Okay, so first name plus last name I want to show. And finally, I want to show document.write full name. And finally, what I want to do is I just want to execute this in the browser, default browser. So my prompt got actually, my prompt is asking enter your first name. My first name is something like Srinivas. And okay, and it is asking another prompt. Another prompt is something like a last name. I'm trying to giving the Gorantla, and finally Srinivas Gorantla got printed on the browser. So why it is printing on top of the browser? Why? Because I'm writing here full name is equal to first name plus. I will take a plus here and I will take underscore. First name plus underscore plus last name. First name plus underscore plus last name. Just try to re-execute it. First name is something like Srinivas and last name something like Gorantla. And finally, okay, what is output now? Srinivas Gorantla. Output is Srinivas Gorantla. If you want, you can write a document.write however you want. Document.write however you want. For example, I want to write something like full name is plus. This is called a string concatenation. I'm concatenating multiple strings now. First name is something like Srinivas and last name is something like Gorantla. When I entered first name, that was stored in the variable called first name. When I entered a second name or last name Gorantla, that is also got stored. And finally, output is your document.write. Full name is Srinivas Gorantla. I got my output. Full name is Srinivas Gorantla. Yeah. This is a way of working with the prompt messages. Prompts are very, very important in the real time. And alert messages are important. At the same time, prompt messages are important. There are two things we got discussed. The next concept is, everybody got to understand prompt? Any questions with prompt? Alerts, prompts, document.write, console.log. So all these are actually basically a JavaScript functions. Everything is very, very important in the real time. Please remember in the client side. Please remember all these functions in the client side. Don't worry, I will provide all the notes with you, all the cheat sheet with you. And my notes also I will share with you. Don't worry. The next concept is access elements or classes or tags. Or IDs from HTML to JavaScript. How to access your elements or classes or IDs from HTML to JavaScript? Accessing is very simple. First, we will see access elements or tags. First concept is accessing elements or tags. This is the first method. And the second method is access classes from HTML to JavaScript. The next method is third method is access IDs from HTML to JavaScript. So syntaxes you have to remember. Syntaxes are very, very important. For the first one, remember one thing, elements are stored in HTML array based, nothing but you will be having 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Same concept for the classes also. Classes are stored in HTML array based 0, 1, 2, 3, 9. And here the point is very simple. IDs are in EQ. In EQ, nothing but what? We don't put array for IDs. Every ID is different. Every ID is in EQ. So that is the reason IDs are in EQ. Okay, guys, please take a 10 to 15 minutes break. Again, we will connect 3:15 or 3:20. Again, we will connect 3:20. Same meeting ID. Please join again 3:20. Join again, everybody, 3:20. So take a coffee break and come again 3:20. Thanks, bye. I will share the recorded video, no problem.